Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I will show you which statement can be true. So now I want to answer step by step. So we have four statements in here, but there are only one correct statement. Now we need to analyze the first one. The function has an s-intercept, that means y equals to number 0. But if we look carefully, x squared minus b squared, that is about x squared minus b squared. So this is about identities. So in this one, we can put into 8 minus b multiplied by 8 plus b. So this one, that is about s minus b multiplied by s plus b. We divide by s minus b. So this one and this one, they cancel. So we have y equals to s plus b. But we put y equals to number 0. So we put number 0 cone here. So that means we have s equals to negative b. So this statement number 1 is correct. Now let's go to number 2. The function has a horizontal asymptote at y equals to number 0. So we can see that after we simplify, you got y equals to s plus b. When s go to infinity or negative infinity, you can see that this one, they don't get about y equal to number 0. So this one is wrong. The next one, that is about vertical asymptote. That means s equals to b. So but we can see that we have s minus b. However, in the next one, they cancel. So that means they just like the graph like this, but in here we have the y dot. So that means in this one, that is not about vertical asymptote. So this one is wrong. And the last one, the function has a point of discontinuity at b to p. So when we put about b in here, because we have s minus b, so that means s equals to b, because we cannot divide by number 0 in here. So when we put b, go back to y equal to s plus b, we have 2b, and this is the y point in here, and that's it correct. So we have 1 and number 4. They are the correct. This is the end. Thank you for watching.